So this first album, this is our debut album for our band. It's called Hashtag Feeling Frisky. And we've been working on it for a couple of years now, you know. To tell you the truth, the reason we couldn't finish it earlier was we had a lineup change in the band where our first bass player, Mr. Danny Murray, he left us. And after that, we had a little bit of problem where we were solving it through getting different bass players and, you know. So that took us a little extra time to finish the whole process. And apart from that, we produced it on our own, you know. We didn't go through anything this time because it's the first time and we want to experience all the studio work that we can learn from. And I guess we all grew as musicians after this album, you know. And it's a great album. You guys should listen to it. It has a lot of love songs. One of the best songs is called Thinking About You. It's about missing somebody, you know. It's about missing the love of your life. That's how we say it. And songs like Not For You, it's about being cheated by the girl you like, you know. And we have a song called Vain. That's also about a girl letting you go. And a love song called Prize Gold Medal Girl. That song is nice. It's
Ooh, a sweet love song.
a sweet love song for everybody, you know. You can dedicate it to your girls because it's a prize gold medal girl. You can dedicate it to even a grandmother, you know. That kind of song we wanted to make, and I guess it came out well. And we did live drums, Valentino. He did a really good job on it, and Angu, live
Yeah.
guitars, man. So that's all we can say for now. Okay. Arunachal is the first place we visited for the album re after the for this album tour, and it's the first place we actually went to with the album. So it was very exciting for us, and they did a good reception. They let us headline the second night. On the third night was Yung Vimam's team from US. I mean from Sweden. He's
Sweden,
a neoclassical guitarist. But yeah, they really enjoy it, you know. They dance to our tracks because they usually like to dance with us, and we enjoy it. Angu went up on the stage and, you know, doing
yeah.
his Lee and
He was
Valentino.
a really good night, actually.
And yeah, and people came up to us. They wanted to buy our albums, and they bought about say 10 albums this time,
10 copies, yeah.
ten
10 to
copies, yeah.
10.
And it was great, you know. We were so happy that they actually support our music. And after seeing us live, the reason that they wanted to buy the albums, that's like a great achievement for us as a band. And that's pretty much what I can say. And Angu, he threw a few albums from the stage, you know,
Yes.
and they were all fighting for the album. I guess that was good. You guys should check out the review of the Orange Festival. Maybe you'll have a clearer picture.
Well, regarding that, I guess we all work really hard. As a musician, we do whatever we can
Yeah.
for
Playing
our
gigs for
survival, playing.
album. Yeah.
Not only among ourselves, we go play with other musicians
Yeah.
where they hire us as session musicians. So through that and through our gig as a band, and from there, whatever we can get the funds, we keep separate funds for the album and whatever promotion we have to do
Yeah.
with the money. And yeah,
So
that's about it.
basically it's like we go for gigs, you know. People call us different. Sometimes we perform in all different places. Even we do commercial music, man. We're musicians after all. But all the money that we get from different places, you know, we like what he said, we're actually funding our original music through that. Because we're not working anything else. We don't have how do you call it, a day job or any kind of business right now. We're just This is our plan A. There's no plan B for us. We're not gonna go anywhere else and try to do something else apart from music.
You're feeding music with music.
Yeah, so
It's
that's
somewhat
yeah.
like that.
We're feeding our
Our original music
music with the other
commercial music.
yeah, with commercial music that we
With the
do in Delhi.
music that we listen
Yeah.
to. Yeah.
I mean, yeah, that's what we do, you know. We do from hotels to parties to weddings, man. But the thing is, in the end of the day, we express ourselves through our music, and I guess that's the most important thing
Yeah.
for us all. I feel like personally is in Mizoram, they already have such a great music scene, you know. So many musicians, so many good singers, and so many bands. They're really good, and if you actually go there, you'll find that everyone is a good musician, everyone can sing. But when it comes to festival, festival is more about the government support and the government taking the initiative, which and we have a good scene out there with the gospel scene also, which is big, you know, the churches.
Plus they have the big festival like Saptarkhud,
yeah,
Antrium festival, and
but it stays mostly local.
Local, yeah.
They over there is more like Mizoram songs. They like Mizoram songs.
And if you talk about Zai Mizoram, we were also a part of the helping hand for that, and we really tried our best, you know, and it happened, and it's great that it happened, and I hope more people come up with initiatives to do that, you know. That's all we can say right now.
Well, when we play our original music, it's like they do enjoy a lot, but sometimes it's different, you know. Suddenly people come up and say, hey, Bollywood.
Yeah. In Delhi, we once had a gig where they wanted Punjabi music.
And then they also, physically pulled
but also
off the plug.
Depends on the venue. And
the venue, yeah, that's there. That was a wrong gig.
Yeah.
We played our song full on rocking wala, and then what happened was they pulled the plug. They wanted a bit of the Punjabi songs. And I mean, we don't do that. But out here in Northeast, we haven't played too much though. We've just played a Zero Festival, Zai Mizoram Festival, and now Orange Festival.
Yeah.
And we hope, you know, things get better as we go
but
on.
But the best part, whenever we play here in North, is it's like we always get this positive energy.
Yeah.
It's like we see everyone happy, smiling. Mm. No one's like getting aggressive or, you know, getting pissed off. That's the good part.
And the people actually listen to us.
Yeah, they actually listen, plus they actually have fun, which is like really.
But in a way,
great for us. Yeah.
Even in it's all the same. It depends on, you know, the gig kind of thing. You know, so far I don't think when it comes to Frisky Pints, being Frisky Pints, we've always had a good gig. I don't remember a bad one.